Between this Korean girl and this Scandinavian girl, which one is actually a white girl? You probably picked the Scandinavian, right? Because she's European, and Europeans are white. But here's the twist. The Korean girl actually has porcelain white skin, while the Scandinavian skin is pinkish beige. So who's really white? This simple question reveals something deeper. That calling people white, black, or brown is actually a social construct, not a scientific reality. Human skin doesn't follow political categories. It follows the laws of evolution, sunlight, and adaptation. And today we'll clear all the confusion and understand what fair skin truly is. Not as a label, but as a biological and visual spectrum. Because fair skin isn't one color. It's a whole world of tones, born from different climates, diets, and evolutionary paths. But before we explore the types of fair skin, we first need to understand why we humans even have fair skin to begin with. Well, all humans came from Africa, where dark skin, rich in melanin, protected our bodies from the strong tropical sun by shielding DNA, preserving folate, and acting like a natural sunscreen. But when some groups migrated north into Eurasia, where sunlight was weak, skies cloudy, and winters long, dark skin became a disadvantage because melanin blocks UV rays needed to make vitamin D. And without enough vitamin D, people suffer weak bones, reduced fertility, and poor immunity. However, the older indigenous Europeans were darker. The diverse European hunter-gatherers who lived all over Europe had medium to dark brown skin tones, and their meat-based diet supplemented them with enough vitamin D, so the lack of sunlight wasn't even a big problem. But the real turning point came with the shift to farming, brought by Near Eastern Anatolian farmers who spread agriculture across Europe and mixed with the local hunter-gatherers. This new lifestyle brought a different diet, grain-based and low in vitamin D, unlike the previous animal-rich diet. As a result, people lost a major nutrient source. In sunny regions, that wasn't a big issue, but in cloudy northern lands, it became life-threatening. Natural selection began to favor lighter skin that could absorb more sunlight and produce vitamin D more efficiently. This combination of low UV light and low vitamin D diets accelerated the spread of fair skin across northern Eurasia. And over thousands of years, humans in different regions independently evolved fair skin, a process called convergent evolution, through different genetic changes that produce similar results. In West Eurasians, genes like SLC24A5 and SLC45A2 reduced melanin and created beige, golden, and pinkish tones, while in East Eurasians, other genes such as OCA2 and HERC2 caused light skin with yellowish or ivory undertones. Within the West Eurasian world, two main types eventually emerged, the light olive type and the pinkish pale type. Let's start with the oldest, the light olive, the warmest tone in the fair spectrum among West Eurasians. Though I categorize it as brown in my old videos, it's actually too light to be called brown. Under sunlight, it reflects a soft bronze or greenish glow, like warm honey on stone. Its beauty lies in balance. Olive skin carries both eumelanin, the brown-black pigment that gives depth, and pheomelanin, which adds subtle golden warmth, with a touch of carotene from diet and genetics. Together, these create its signature glow, warm, complex, and alive, but comes with a famous greenish tint, which brought its olive name, which, unlike Shrek, is not a real pigment. It's an optical illusion caused by how light scatters through skin. Yellow tones from carotene and pheomelanin, mixed with moderate brown melanin, slightly muting the red of blood underneath. The result is the soft olive gray reflection in certain lighting. Olive skin sits right between warm and cool. It tans easily, rarely burns, and turns golden rather than red. In winter, it can look muted or ashy. In summer, it deepens into radiant bronze, but the undertone never changes. Only the surface tone shifts with light and season. But this tone isn't one shade, as it comes in many different shades, such as light olive skin, which is faint beige or sandy hue with a whisper of green or gold. Medium olive is deeper and more balanced, showing a soft bronze or honey tint. Golden olive shines with rich amber warmth. Shallow olive appears softer and paler, with a greenish-beige cast. And dark olive, by contrast, is deeper and earthier, golden bronze under the sun, but keeping its olive undertone in the shade. In Europe, these tones dominate much across southern Europe, from the Iberian Peninsula and southern France to Italy, the Balkans and the Caucasus, yet remains rare in the British Isles and the Alpine North, where cooler pink and ivory tones prevail. In Asia, these tones dominate across Anatolia, the Levant, and Mesopotamia, and even among Dardic and Iranic-speaking peoples. You'll also find them as a second majority tone after medium brown among northwestern Indians and Pakistanis. In the Arabian Peninsula, it's also a second majority among Gulf and Hijazi Arabs, and also the highland people of Yemen. In Africa, it's common along the Mediterranean coast, the Atlas Mountains and the Nile Delta. Even farther south, it can be seen in smaller percentages among Cape Coloureds, Rehoboth Busters, Griquas, Ethiosemites, Barawas, and Sudanese Arabs. Beyond these regions, olive tones surface in countless mixed West Eurasian population, from mestizos in Latin America to Afro-Europeans, Wajans, Central Asian Turks, and even people with partial Aboriginal, Austronesian, and Melanesian descent. Wherever it appears, olive skin bridges light and dark, nature's perfect middle ground between the pink of the north and the gold of the south, unlike the next one, which is pinkish pale. Pinkish pale or peach skin defines northwestern Europe, Scandinavia, through northern Russia all the way to Vladivostok, the land of pale winters and gentle light. This skin tone has very low melanin, and the colors underneath, the red of hemoglobin and the yellow of carotene, began to show. That's why this skin looks rosy, peach, or creamy ivory depending on blood flow and diet. Unlike the golden southern tones, northern skin is cooler, translucent, and reactive. Light scatters through thin skin and shallow capillaries, revealing a natural blush, especially in cold weather. These capillaries expand and contract rapidly, deepening that pink glow. This skin burns easily, turns poorly, but it's perfectly adapted to its home. It captures sunlight efficiently to produce vitamin D during long, dim winters. And just like olive skin, it comes in many subtle shades, such as cream, which is pale beige with soft golden warmth, like milk kissed by sunlight. Porcelain pink is translucent and rosy. These two colors are enhanced by seafood-rich diets full of omega fats and carotene, and are mostly found among Germanics and coastal Celts, from the North Atlantic to Anglo-Saxons, Baltics, and Scandinavians. Snow-colored skin is nearly colorless with a cool, silvery undertone, while alabaster reflects light like polished stone, common among Finno-Ugric people and inland Celts. And lastly, ivory, pale but faintly golden beneath, shines among Slavs and Northern Balkan peoples. Beyond Europe, it comes in very low numbers among Levantines, Iranics, Dardics, and even Highland Berbers, especially among their ginger peoples. And under gray skies, this skin turns pale ivory. Under sunlight, it glows with a soft peach tint, the fairest, most light-sensitive complexion of the West Eurasian world. Delicate, luminous, and evolutionary precise. And its East Eurasian alternative is yellowish-pale, which belongs mainly to East Eurasians, a separate evolutionary path that reach fair skin through different genes. East Eurasian skin holds more pheomelanin, the yellow-red pigment, and less eumelanin, the dark brown pigment, combined with thicker collagen. This hides the redness of blood vessels, giving that smooth, even yellowish tone. Diets rich in carotenoids from rice, vegetable, and fish also enhance its gentle golden warmth. In the north, among Manchurians, Koreans, Northern Chinese, Mongolians, Japanese, and Siberians, the skin is light but resilient. It rarely burns or turns red, but it turns into muted beige or soft gold. Further south, stronger sunlight deepens this base into creamy golds and warm beige. The dominant tones across southern China, mainland and island Southeast Asia, and out toward Polynesia and even Madagascar, proof of how this golden lineage spread. Between the two lies a lesser-known tone, found among native North American peoples. It's a temperate beige, blending faint yellow and red undertones, light enough for the snow and dim light, yet rich enough to guard against the glare of summer sun. All these skin tones, from light olive to pinkish pale and yellowish pale, is nature's own compromise between sunlight and survival. Two hemispheres, two genetic paths, one purpose, to live in light. And if you enjoy this exploration of human skin tones, check out my other videos. One where I break down the types of human skin color, and another similar to this, where I explore deeper about dark skin. And as always, stay curious, stay smart, and thank you very much for watching.